Guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to do an update for my single ladies and my man Matt, and I'm so excited for this update. I have new pants. I'm so excited. 3 months went by and I hit my first pants, and then the next month I hit two new pants. Let's start out with my Morphe palette. I'm so excited. This is one of the new pants. I'm so excited. So I will insert a picture of what it looked like last time, and I can just tell you, I only had two pants, and that was in, you know, long road down. It was the first and the third shade. I have pan! I'm so excited. And this is a decent amount of pan, actually. So I have three pants. Exciting. I have not used this shade once this month at all, actually. I have stopped setting my primer, so that is basically why. And I'm panning a white eyeshadow that I use on my brow bone instead of that one. So that is I'm taking a break from that shadow. Every single time I say that sentence, I'm on a break. I take a break. I think about was an Rachel from Friends. You were on a break.
We were on a break.
We were on a break. We were on a break.
We were on a break.
We really were on a break.
I used the shade that I had panned on this month every single day for 4 months straight in my crease. 4 months. I have it in my crease today for the last time in a very long time. So yeah, and I have not used this month this shade this month at all since I had panned. 2 months? No, 1 month. I have used this today to set the black liner, and I have used that one in my brows quite a few times. And let's go over to the other side. I have used this in my crease a lot, and I have used this in my outer corner a lot instead of that one, because this is a little bit warmer and I really like that together with this orangey kind of thing. I have not used the dark shadow today except for that one for my liner. That is basically how I am using this palette. You can see the use on that shadow. Yeah, you can. Ooh, the brush hair on that brush is it is a little bit more stiff than other synthetic brushes. English. Well, I'm thinking what shade I am going to use instead of that one. That is very similar to it, so maybe I'm using this one or maybe one of these. Yeah. So I'm going to use this, or this for my crease next time. I haven't decided, but you will know and I will tell you next time. If you want to see me using this palette in my everyday look, I will link my everyday makeup routine, because I talk more about that and how I apply it. Now for my next pan. And yes, you guessed right, it is a single. I'm so excited! It is the single shadow from Kiko in number 18. It is the high pigment shadow. It is the gold shade. I'm so excited. So obviously I'm going to replace this with another shade. I had a hard time picking out a new shade. Whoa, I had a hard time. But I just thought, just pick another gold kind of shadow. It is living in my smaller C palette with other shades. I'm so torn about these Makeup Geek shadows because I really don't want to pan them. I really don't want to use them up. I really don't want to hit pan on them. That's just silly, because these are getting older. Yeah, I bought them in 2016. I took them on vacation one summer for a week, and then I have not used them really since, and that was in 17. That's just a little bit embarrassing for a panner's brain. But yeah, this is the shade Cosmopolitan. I don't know if they are making it anymore, because I have heard she is rearranging or redoing her singles. So she discontinued a bunch and then she added new shades. Can you say that? So this is Cosmopolitan. It is a beautiful shadow. It is an orangey gold peachy shimmer shade. It's absolutely beautiful. This is the one right here. That is so stunning. So I thought this was going to be a nice new gold shade that I can use instead of this. Something I have realized. This is going to be kind of a dupe for what I have on my eyes. I just thought about that. Because I am using the next single on top of my L'Oreal Infallible pigment. And it is kind of the same shadow. This is just a little bit more, I don't know, beautiful. So yeah, I'm excited to use this single and trying to hit pan. So let's see how fast or slow I can hit pan on that. So that is my goal overall. Just realized I didn't tell you. The matte palette we are going to use up. When we have used up the matte palette in this project, we're going to just roll in another palette, and then we are going to roll in matte singles. And when we don't have any mattes left in our collection, which I think will never happen, then we're ending this. So it doesn't have an end date. So even though this palette, the Morphe palette, is my Panda palette for 2019, I think I'm just going to roll with that and then adding its shades to another project next year. I have not really decided yet, but it's only May. Wow, yeah, it's me. Wow. So, move on. The single layers, I'm just going to hit pan on my singles, and then eventually when I have pan on all my singles, I'm going to finish them. Big goal, I know. This is the next Kiko shadow in 139. Again, I use this all over my lid, and I'm so close to hitting pan on this. Nope, that is not pan. But it has a massive dip. I'm so excited. I love this shadow so much. I kind of have a dupe that is not as shiny as this, but I can roll that in when I hit pan. I think my goal for this is to hit pan next time, and I think I can do it. So that is the Kiko eyeshadow. Someone told me last time that I can take the magnets out of these single pans, so I have done that, so I can have them in my smaller C palette. This is the high pigment shadow from Kiko in 54. So this is the shade that I didn't really like. I will pop in a look I did last weekend, I think. I played around with it because I really wanted to make it work together with another eyeshadow that I'm trying to make work. I used this in my crease. It was a little bit more satin for my liking in my crease, but I really, really liked the effect. I do love it on my lower lash line. And yes, I have tried every single base with this and it does not work. But. I just thought for a minute my camera broke, but luckily it didn't. So yeah, this eyeshadow is really nice in the crease and on my lower lash line, all over my lid. Nope, out of corner, not really. So this is going to be a crease shade. I have not used it as a blush. Someone did comment on that. I think it was Jessica. Jessica, was it you? I think she is inspired by her makeup mix-up challenge with Amanda and Janine. Well, I need to try to use it as a blush. I have a fair amount of blush, so I hope it's not working as a blush. The last single that I have in this project is this one. It is a small Benefit blush. Blush all over my head. This is a Benefit eyeshadow single from a holiday collection, and this is called Call Me Buff. It is a satin cream shade. Yeah, you can see the shine here. I have it, okay, that is not the shininess. I use it in my inner corner and up to my brow bone, and then I use the white shadow that I'm panning. So that is what I use that for. It's not really going fast or anything, but I really enjoy using it. And sometimes I forget the blinding inner corner, so I just have a satin finish there, and that's really nice, actually. If you want to see my C palette, this is how it is looking like. That is the white shadow that I was talking about. This is the red blush I'm panning. And that is the other shadow that I'm trying to make work. And not going very well. Just thought about franking it with another highlighter so it can work. Because it has a more creamy texture. It's not dry. So maybe it will work as a highlighter. I tried it on its own. But I think it is going to be really nice for summer, actually. Ooh, maybe I should try that. Or just crush it up and put it in a body lotion. That would work. Let's do that. That sounds more manageable. That's everything for this update. My camera have cut me off way too many times now. So I'm just going to sign off before it does that again. I hope you guys enjoyed, and please check out the other lovely ladies in this collab. They are amazing, and I'm sure you follow them already if you watch me. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a like, subscribe down below, so you don't miss out on my next video and the next update in this project. And yeah, until my next video, take care. Bye.